Todd Martin, Tucson Tamale Company. I was 16 years ago. I moved out here, went over to my girlfriend. She's now my wife, but at the time she was my girlfriend. Went over to her parents' house. She said we were going to make tamales. And it was Saturday morning, 9 o'clock in the morning. I showed up. I thought there'd be a few people there. There was 20 people, 5 cases of beer, 5 bushels of corn. And we just had a blast all day. So from that, I just started making tamales. I was in corporate America for a long time. I was actually with a software company, Intuit. I managed their support website. But I always wanted to have my own business. We started St. Phil's, it's been 2 years and 9 months. So almost 3 years. I think the first year was very instrumental because almost everybody that... every customer that saw us the first year at the market hadn't heard of us, so we acquired a lot of new customers. Now, almost everybody, our name in Tucson is really well known, so, you know, it's not really about new customers anymore, but it is about servicing our existing customers, because now they expect us, you know, it's convenient. We're down here at Broadway and Tucson Boulevard. People that live up north, it's a lot easier for them to go there on Sundays. So it was really instrumental the first year in business, and now it's about maintaining. The reason is it gets our name out there. It is a great way to advertise. People see us. We also, you know, obviously we make money there. But supporting the markets, because we help support the farmers. We buy, you know, as much stuff locally as we can. You know, one thing, our coffee, it's not grown locally, obviously, but it's a local coffee roaster. So, you know, all of those kinds of things. And we actually met him at the farmer's market. It's a great community event, too. I mean, you really get, like when you talk to Dorothy and Paul, I mean, all the vendors know each other. There's a lot of regulars. It's really just like a regular market, but it's a one-day market. And there's just a whole different vibe to it. And there's just something more unique than, I don't know, the regular supermarkets. We buy as much locally as we can. We're a member of Tucson Originals, which is a group of 50 locally owned restaurants. And, you know, that helps us. We do a lot of fundraising events, so we raise money for different organizations in the city. We also do, you know, a lot of donations. This year we're going to donate between gift certificates for like auctions for fundraisers and tamales to feed folks with. We're going to donate over $5,000 worth of product and gift certificates. We support the community every way we can.
I personally joined a Saber about 3 years ago, you know, and he started it a long time ago. In fact, he did it personally himself. You know, because he started, like I said, there's the humble beginnings of everything. You have to start somewhere. He started as a single person doing it himself, going to all these markets. And he would actually go to the markets and come home, make the hummus and everything himself, you know, without any employees. And then after that, he would get up the next morning, and sometimes he would do two different markets in a single day, you know. And then as a result, you know, he ended up getting better employees and stuff. And at the same time, we support the local markets, even if it's a small one or a large one. Like Tucson one is very good. We've been established down there. And so we go down there. You know, I personally go down there 110 miles each way to go down there because we support Manish and his market. And at the same time, we do very well over there, you know. And then, but we also do the local markets like in, we do Casa Grande. You know, one of the slowest markets ever, but we do it because it's local and it supports the person that's running the market. You know, we want to give goodwill to everyone. And the philosophy of our company is nothing is too small, nothing is too big. You know, and, you know, we don't pick and choose like a lot of them do. Like if it's a bad market, they try to pull out. No, we're in there because we know where our humble beginnings were, you know, and we want to go the next level. Now, by far, we're not, you know, where we want to be right now. You know, we want to be even further, you know, and we want everybody to know, hey, you know, they go to somebody's house and say, hey, that's not Dr. Hummus, you know. So, you know, that's, and then number one thing about our company is, and Saber, he definitely always points out to us all the time, he doesn't care what happens as long as you take care of your customers, you know. And if you take care of your customers, your customers will take care of you.